Hello students, hello everyone. So after designing a piston head, our second topic to design is a piston case. But before getting into the piston rings, we should know about different aspects and features of our piston rings. So here in this case, we are going to design two aspects of our rings. One is piston ring grooves as well as piston rings itself. But before getting into this design specification, we should know what is application and what is function of our piston ring. Function of a piston ring is to provide proper sealing between piston and piston cylinder assembly. So it provides a sealing between piston head, or you can say cylinder cavity, and piston or a cylinder wall. So piston will create a radial pressure around the surface of our cylinder. So it should be, or it should work in this piston, or it should work against the pressure of this wall sufficiently, that much it will not leak any type of fuel from our piston cavity. So there are two types of rings which are takes place, as we have discussed in previous chapter, while we are designing different aspect of, or we are discussing this different aspect of our piston. One is compression rings. This compression rings, the top, if I am considering there are four rings in our piston, then top three ring will be represented or called as a pressure or compression rings here, which provides or which seals a wall between our cylinder and piston. And the last ring, which is called the oil ring or also oil scraper, it provides continuous lubrication to our piston cylinder assembly. So there are two functions of our piston ring. One is to provide compression and as well as oil ring. But our design will be against this stress generated in this R ring. So there are two types of also piston rings, also called as a piston. They have also springing effect, or you can say they act as a more of a spring. So in our case, our concern is to provide not only compression as well as lubrication in terms of a springing effect. So our design is mainly concerned with that. But before getting into this, we should know about what kind of material we are going to require. So due to that springing effect, there should be material which has more compress or damping, or you can say springing effect. One is a gray cast iron, or so you can use a nodular cast iron, which has a good amount of graphite in that, as well as you can use alloy cast iron, which has a good springing effect. Clear? So here our material of this ring will be more of a cast iron, which has that springing properties. Clear? Or you can say vibration properties, which can withstand this kind of shock loads, or you can say bearing pressure provided by our piston or cylinder wall. So now we discuss about different features. So there are vertical dimensions of our piston as well as radial dimension. What exactly look like this? This ring is a flat strip. Okay, flat strip, which has a thickness as well as width, and this flat strip, it cut into paste, and after that it will revolve, or you can say forge, into a circular shape. Clear? So basically it is a flat strip which forge and convert into a round shape. Clear? So ultimately our criteria is to design a strip. Clear? Which has two features. One is radial thickness, clear, which is also called as thickness, and another is axial thickness. So in case of ring, we have to design two things, radial as well as axial thickness. And in case of our piston ring grooves, we have to design two things. One is at what distance we have to provide these grooves, clear, which we have discussed in piston head, clear, which is called B1. Also, it's a piston top length, clear. So to determine distance from upper edge to our ring, it should be B1, which is also called piston top length. And in case of our axial thickness, clear, and one is axial in the sense vertical thickness, one is its radial thickness. So we are going to design radial thickness, axial thickness of rings, and then top length. Clear what is the difference or distance of our first ring from, clear, or you can say ring section from our edge of top of our piston. After that, we are going to discuss about distance between consecutive two rings, which is V2, and ultimately we will determine gap, because this ring will not going to a continuous ring. It is section, or it is open at one end. Clear, it is not total circle. It is open, or you can say cut at one end. So we are going to determine that gap between two ends of ring. Clear? One is after mounting on piston, and another is before mounting. After mounting piston, it will considered by a diameter, or it will depend on diameter of the piston, and before it is depending on axial thickness of the piston. As well as here we are going to use some of the, or we are going to consider some of empirical relation of this our piston ring section. So let's start with our piston ring. First design is to radial thickness. What radial thickness? Radial thickness of our piston ring. So it will be the radial thickness of the strip which is converted or forged into, clear, into a ring. Clear? So radial thickness, it is determined, or we have got in previous lecture or video as a T1, which is T1 is equal to D under root 3 Pw upon sigma t. Now I will explain which are these quantities. D is nothing but diameter of our piston, or you can say inside diameter of cylinder. Sorry. So D is a diameter of our piston, clear, or inside diameter of cylinder. Pw is a pressure created by wall on our piston ring. So wall pressure, you can say wall pressure, clear, created by cylinder wall on our ring, which has a value of, it should be between 0.025 megapascal to 0.042 megapascal. I will write over here also 0.025 megapascal to 0.042 megapascal. It should be between this one. In ideal scenario, we are going to take it as a 0.035 megapascal. And allowable tensile stress. Allowable tensile stress for a ring material. It should be a gray cast iron or a alloy cast iron. It is compared to piston material, it will be higher. Here, because this ring will come under tensile stress, because the pressure will try to close it up from its open end, and it will create tension in our outside, tension in our ring, and it is between 80 megapascal to 110 megapascal. So it should be between 80 to 110, or it will be between 80 to 110 megapascal. We will take it as a 85 in an ideal scenario. After that, this is our radial thickness. Radial thickness is more of a thickness, or you can say strip thickness. Clear? Because this ring is made from a long thin strip into a circular strip, as I have told you. After that, we are going to determine axial thickness. Clear? Radial from top view, axial from a side view. This axial thickness will be a lesser than our radial thickness, but it has an empirical formula. There are two equation, or here there are two empirical formula to determine this axial thickness. One is to depending on its radial thickness, when is related to its radial thickness, which is 0.7 T1 to T1, clear, which is 0.7 T1 to T1, where T1 is its radial thickness, clear. And second formula, which is D upon 10 NR, 10 N suffix R. D is diameter of piston, NR. NR is nothing but number of rings. If it is 3, then you have to take it as 3, and total number of rings. So NR is total number of rings. These two formula both are applicable in any of the example. You can use any of them. Clear? Okay. If you get different thickness from the different formula, it is not area of concern. We can take it as any of them. You can take any of them. But in most of the cases, from my point of view, we are going to use this formula, which is more related to our radial thickness rather than diameter. Clear? Okay. From this formula, you can also determine number of rings. How many number of rings you are going to take? Clear? As well as fourth are empirical formula rather than a derived formula. After that, we are going to determine width of the top head, which is also going to represent, distance of piston ring section to our topmost area, or you can say topmost surface edge. So it is represented by B1. What is B1? B1 is T suffix H2. It is related to piston head thickness. This B1 is related to more to piston head thickness. Here it will be in terms of TH. It is also an empirical formula. It is in terms of TH to 1.2 TH. Clear? So our B1 top length is TH, which is related to TH, which is related to our piston head thickness, which we have determined previously. Previous section, one is due to gas pressure and temperature or heat transfer, depending on that. So it will the B1 will depending on these are piston thickness, and it is actually TH to 1.2 TH. So our two features, here are two features. Ring features are different, and this feature, this B1, B2, and all the gap, it is in our piston. Here, this two is related to rings, and after that, they are going to relate it to piston. Clear? Okay? Because this ring section will be machined in our piston. Clear? Ring design isolation in isolation separately, and this machining is provided differently. After that, we are going to determine width of the ring length. Clear? What is the width of our ring length? Or you can say it is distance between two consecutive rings. We have discussed in our first lecture what is different nomenclature or what is different features of our or geometrical features, more of our geometrical features of our piston. So B2 represent width of the ring length. Clear? What is width of a ring length? Is nothing but the distance between two rings. Clear? That area which is differentiated two rings, that is distance of a ring length, which is going to depend on our axial thickness of our ring. Clear? Which is vertical feature of our ring, piston. Clear? And value of that is 0.75 T2. T2 is nothing but axial thickness. 2 T2. Clear? 0.75 T2 to T2. We are going to take a lower amount of in each end, or you can say most lowest value in our examples. After that, so width of the ring length is nothing but a distance between two consecutive rings. And ultimately, we are going to determine gap between two ring ends. As I have told you, this ring is not a total fully solid ring. There is a gap between two ends of a ring. One is to determine before mounting, clear? So, and one is to after mounting. Here, I have put two equations. One is mounted ring. Mounted means after mounting on our piston assembly. So, the value of this mounted ring, or sorry, gap between two ends of our ring, or two end of our ring, is 0.02 capital D, where capital D is diameter of a piston. Because this depends on diameter of piston, we should know, we should already have determined diameter of piston 2.04 D. So after mounting this ring on our piston, we have to determine its gap depend on diameter of our piston. And normally, without mounting, the gap between these two ends, it is 3.5 T1 to N T1, where T1 is radial thickness of our piston. So normally it depends on radial thickness, and after mounting it depends on diameter of piston. So this is your ring section, or more of a you can say piston feature, which is called a ring section design. Let's a quick recap of this. The function of this piston ring is to provide proper sealing between cylinder and piston. Clear? There are two types of rings. One is compression ring and another is oil ring. What is function of compression ring? Compression rings provide proper sealing and springing effect to our piston, as well as oil ring provide lubrication to our piston. So depending on its function, we have selected material or determined material for our rings. One is gray cast iron and another is alloy cast iron. After determining that, we are going to design different features of our ring. There are several features of our ring. Because this ring is a strip. Here it's a strip, or you can say rectangular cross-sectional strip. So there are two thicknesses, one is radial thickness and one is axial thickness. Both we have determined depending, one is depending on its wall pressure and another depending on its empirical formula. There are two equations for that, one is depends on radial thickness, another is for our diameter. After that we have determined width of the top end, which is also a distance between top end of the cylinder to the ring section. Here we have determined TS to 1.2 TS. After that, ring length is nothing but distance between two consecutive rings, 0.75 T2 to T2, and ultimately in the end we have determined gap between two ends of the ring, because it is not total solid ring. So there are two features of there are two gaps. One is after mounting and another is before mounting. After mounting is depending on diameter, which is 0.002 diameter to 0.004, and normally is 3.5 T1 to 4 T1. I hope you got all the features and all the aspect of design of ring. After this, we are going to determine piston barrel and piston skirt and ultimately piston pin. Clear? So we have done with our piston ring section or ring design. Thank you. Thank you so much.